How to make a single button automatic anchor. The ocean in Stormworks is pretty deep, so you almost always need a large or huge winch for an anchor. The large winch can extend to 150 meters, while the huge winch can extend to 600 meters. In its most basic form, an anchor would be a maggle and an electrical cable anchor. You might also want additional maggles for a more secure connection and details or decorations to add weight. Go into the microcontroller editor and give the microcontroller the name Auto Anchor. Change the width to 1 and the length to 5. Click on the Logic tab. Click the Add node 5 times and space these out on the schematic. Leave 2 of these nodes as input and change the other 3 to output. The first input is to deploy the anchor and retract it. Name it Anchor Button. The second input is to detect the maggle's connected state. Name it Anchor Maggle Connected. The first output is to raise the winch. Name it Anchor Up. The second output is to lower the winch, so name it Anchor Down. And the third output is to turn on the maggle, name it Activate Maggle. Change into the logic editor and move your inputs to the left and your outputs to the right. Open the logic gates menu and place down one capacitor, two NOT gates, and one AND gate. Connect the anchor button input to the capacitor and the capacitor to the activate maggle output. Change the capacitor's charge time to 1 second and the discharge to 0 seconds. This is to stop the anchor from potentially getting magnetized to your ship's hull by giving it a chance to drop away before turning on. Connect the anchor button input to the NOT gate and the NOT gate to the anchor up output. Connect the anchor button input to the AND gate and the AND gate to the anchor down output. Connect the anchor maggle connected input to the second NOT gate and the NOT gate into the empty input of the AND gate. Save this microcontroller, naming it Auto Anchor. Now we have the logic, let's build an anchor. Go back into the vehicle editor and prepare your ship. Make sure you have a battery and a toggleable button. Place a winch that has the length you need. Then place an electrical cable anchor on a separate subgrid. An easy way to do this is to place a hinge and then connect your electrical cable anchor to the other end and delete the hinge. Pivots and tracks also work for this technique. Now place a maggle on the electrical cable anchor. Open your parts menu and search for the Auto Anchor microcontroller and place it on your boat. Change into logic view and starting with the on-off data, connect the anchor button node to the toggle button. Connect the maggle connected node to the winch's on-off output. Connect the anchor up node to the winch's up input. Connect the anchor down node to the winch's down input. And connect the activate maggle node to the winch's on-off input. Now focus in on the electrical cable anchor and maggle. We need to connect the electrical anchor's output to the maggle's input and the electrical anchor's input to the maggle's output. If you're building a big anchor with multiple maggles, I recommend you use the middle maggle's connected node to send data back through the electrical anchor. Now change to the electric logic. Connect the electrical anchor to the maggle and the winch and button to your battery. The electrical cable between the winch and the anchor transfers electricity to the maggle. Change to the rope logic and connect the winch to the electrical anchor. I'm going to set my winch speed to 1.5 before I spawn. Spawn in your boat and push the button. Depending on the size of your boat and the position of your winch, you'll want to change the capacitor's charge timing to allow the anchor to pass by the entirety of the hull before activating. Use a longer charge time for a taller boat and a shorter charge time for a smaller boat. Thanks for watching, leave us a like, and I'll see you next time.